most of you have joined in and I'll start. Okay guys, yesterday I just completed this answer, that is role of technology in strengthening the performance management process. Now let us go ahead with the next answer, which is performance management cycle. Okay, Vishal Mishra has joined in. I think he is a marketing student. I don't know.
No, ma'am.
He's a marketing student, na?
No, ma'am. HR student.
He's an HR student. Okay, okay. All right. Okay. So that answer was done, and we have seen how, you know, technology helps in making the performance management more effective, okay, as it is integrating all the data at one place, okay, which is, and the access to all the stakeholders and top management will help the company to take some important decisions. Okay. There are a few students at the waiting. Okay, let me just admit all of them and then I start. Vinayak Jha is a HR student or a marketing student? He's a marketing student. Okay, before that I proceed, at 9:30 today, you have a session on placement. Okay, I think they are going to discuss on plan of action. Our college in association with TechnoServe. So please be there. It is for your benefit. Okay, and especially this, you know, after this online teaching learning and this pandemic issues, it will be very difficult for you to, you know, find out job for yourself. Okay. So be very active with the placement cell so that, you know, they help you with giving you references of good companies. And they also help you in, you know, grooming your skills. So please be there at 9:30 session today and make the most of it. Okay, now I'm sharing the screen and we begin with the next answer, which is performance management cycle. Actually, this is the only answer which is remaining. Otherwise, our first module is done. Okay. And I started with best practices and role of technology before. Okay. Actually, ye textbook mein ye answer pehle tha. So this was missed out. So I'll just complete this answer and first unit is done. Okay. And then we will begin with the second module in the next session. Today we will complete this answer. I'm sharing the screen. Please tell me if it is visible or not. Performance management cycle. Okay, I hope the screen is visible, students.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
All right, okay. So this is a very simple answer since we have already completed performance management process. This it would be very easy for you to understand this answer. Okay, who is going to read this? Anyone?
Yes, can I?
Yes, yes, Priscilla, you can start.
Performance management cycle. Performance management involves much more than just assigning ratings to the employees. It is a continual cycle that includes the following process. First, planning work beforehand so that expectations and goals can be saved for evaluation. Second, monitoring progress and performance consistently over a period of time. Third, developing the employee's ability to perform through training and work assignments. I rating periodically to review and analyze performance. And fourth, rewarding good performance of the employees.
Okay, this was the next point. It is a type error. I'll just stick it here. Okay. All right. So it states very clearly that performance management is not merely giving rating to your employees. Okay. It is more than that. It is a continuous cycle. Okay. Which starts from planning, monitoring, then, giving them rating periodically and rewarding them. Okay. So let us understand one by one. The first point is saying that, this performance cycle begins with performance planning. I think planning will definitely help the organization to set the goals and performance standards, which can be later on used for, evaluation purposes, right? So you need to first plan, all right? You need to decide in advance, okay, what activities are to be performed to achieve the objectives of the organization, right? So after planning, you are going to monitor the performance and progress of your employees. And this monitoring should be done on regular basis. It should be at least on periodic basis, if not regular. Okay. You need to know that, whether your employees are moving in the right direction or not. Okay. Because if they are not moving according to the plan, the company might not achieve its objectives. Then third one, here it is stated that, you have to make sure that, you are also introducing training and development programs, okay? Just in case if your employees are not going in the right direction or if there are any shortcomings in their conduct, okay? If something is planned and your employees are not able to achieve those plans, definitely you have to infuse certain training and development. Do that, okay? And make sure that, your objectives of training are very clear. Okay. The next is you are going to give ratings to your employees, because if there is no formal rating system, the employee will never understand or will never take the pressure of, giving or delivering quality work. So you need to introduce something called rating. Okay. Once, and that performance rating should be utilized for, important decisions like promotions, like transfer, like layoff, right? So if there is a formal rating system, the employee will also understand that, my work is being evaluated and I have been given certain ratings on my work. Okay. And these ratings are going to affect a lot of things like my continuation, like my career and so many other things like my promotion, whether am I eligible for incentives or not, whether I am a potential employee for succession planning or not, right? So the employee has to do a lot with the rating. The rating should be in a formal system and it should be informed to the employees what ratings are provided to them. Then the next one is rewarding. Students, if your employees are performing good, okay, of course it is the responsibility of the company to reward them. Your best performers, if they are not getting an acknowledgement in terms of rewards, they will not continue with you. Very simple, because they have opportunities outside. So performance cycle starts with planning, monitoring, developing the employee's ability, rating them, and then finally rewarding them. We will understand one by one, but this is just a summary and introduction. I hope there is no difficulty here. If there is no difficulty, we will proceed. Any doubts still here, students?
No, ma'am.
All right. It will be very simple for those who have attended the previous sessions, because we have completed so many answers, which is very much related, like performance management process, features of performance management. Okay, we will begin with this performance management cycle. Step one, which is planning. Okay, Priscilla.
Planning first. Planning means defining expected levels of employee performance and goals for groups and individual employees so as to utilize their efforts towards achieving organizational objectives. It also includes the measurable parameters that will be measured to determine whether expectations and goals are being met. Involving employees in the planning process helps them to understand the goal of the organization, what needs to be done, why it needs to be done, and how well it should be done.
I think very simple to understand this. Here it is just stating that, you know, why planning is important, okay? Why the cycle starts with planning, okay? If you are planning, obviously you have a, you know, a quantifiable parameter to evaluate the employee's performance in later, right? Because you need to have some yardstick, right? You need to have some parameter later on to evaluate the performance. On what basis are you going to check the employee's performance? Kuch toh aapke haath mein hona chahiye na, right? So it starts with planning. Okay. So to begin with, when you plan for your you know, activities in the organization, it helps to set the performance standards. Okay. And if it is measurable, okay, if for instance the plan states something very specific. For instance, it states that, you know, the production department is supposed to produce 5,000 units of brand A in this particular period. Okay. Now, this is the plan of the production department. Very much quantifiable and very much, you know, measurable, right? So, at the end of, after that particular period, okay, now you are going to evaluate, for instance, 1 month. Okay, that production department is supposed to manufacture 5,000 units of brand A within a period of 1 month. So after 1 month is over, I think now the supervisor or the manager can start evaluating. Okay, okay, this 1 month period is done. Okay, the timeline or the deadline is already done. Okay, now let us check how much is the outcome. What is the target achieved or not? Okay. If the target is not achieved, what are the reasons that, you know, the workers were not able to achieve the target? Okay. So this is how planning helps in the later purpose of evaluation, right? So again, over here, it is also mentioned that, you know, you should always involve your employees in the planning process so that you set the most realistic and achievable plans. Okay. Something which is achievable, right? And I think involving your employees from the beginning will always help you later on, okay? So if they are involved in the planning process, okay, eventually they take up the responsibility of, you know, achieving the targets. If I'm not asking my employee and I'm blindly setting the plans and blindly setting the targets, okay, if later on the employees might have an excuse that, you know, this is something very unrealistic with the available resources. You did not ask us, you did not approach us. This performance standard or this target is something not achievable, right? So always make sure that you involve your employees from the beginning, okay, so that they know what is to be done, why it is need to be done, and how it can be done. Okay, so all the questions of, you know, what, why, and how can be answered. So performance management cycle starts with planning. So once the planning is done, comes the next stage, which is monitoring. Okay.
Second, monitoring. Monitoring means regularly measuring and recording performance and providing continuous feedback to employees and work groups on their progress toward reaching their goals. Consistent monitoring provides the opportunity to verify how employees are doing and to identify and resolve any problems early in the course of the review period.
I think very simple to understand what is the purpose of monitoring. Monitoring is because you know whether, you know, employees are moving in the right direction or not. Okay. Monitoring has to do nothing with supervision. Okay. What is supervision when you are just, you know, checking if the employees are doing correct or not. And if you're kind of, you know, the term supervision itself sounds very negative, right? So monitoring is different. Monitoring is, you know, you are trying to understand, okay, if the employees are going in the right direction or not. Okay, and if they are not going in the right direction, you need to resolve those problems, okay, in their conduct. Okay, so this is how monitoring is done. Just guys, 1 minute. All right. So also in the monitoring process, students, you should always give feedback to your employees. If not on regular basis, at least do a periodic feedback. Okay. टीम को भी देना चाहिए, इंडिविजुअल फीडबैक भी देना चाहिए, टीम वाइज फीडबैक भी देना चाहिए, राइट? सो दैट दे नो यू नो इफ दे आर मूविंग इन द राइट डायरेक्शन टू अचीव द गोल्स और नॉट. सो दैट इज मॉनिटरिंग. आई होप देयर इज नो डिफिकल्टी टिल हियर. वी जस्ट स्टार्टेड विद परफॉर्मेंस मैनेजमेंट साइकिल. Okay, since we already have discussed one answer, which is performance management process, I hope this answer is very simple for you to understand. We started with planning, planning is done. Second, we started with monitoring, and we have also discussed how monitoring is done and what is the purpose of monitoring. Moving ahead with the third point, which is developing. All right.
Third, developing. Developing means improving the capability of employees to perform through training, giving assignments that introduce newer competencies or higher level of responsibility. Improving work process. Development efforts can encourage and strengthen good performance and help employees keep us with change in the workplace.
I think developing also means trying to bridge the gap. Okay, in case there is any performance gap in the employee's conduct of work, you need to start developing. Okay, how will you do that? Introduce certain training and development programs, which is going to bridge this gap. Okay, make sure that the required skills are infused in your employees. Okay, and they're well up to date with the, you know, how to perform the work. You can also introduce certain assignments or some, you can also give them some new responsibilities so that they are becoming more competent. Okay, so developing means you're trying to make your employees more skilled. Okay, and they are now much more competent in achieving the organization's objective. Also, students, developing should be done with the purpose of, you know, keeping your employees informed that the company works in dynamic environment and there are changes that might happen. Then you need to be prepared for those changes. You need to be ready to, you know, accept those changes. Right? So developing will help your employee to be mentally prepared for such kind of unforeseen changes that the company might introduce. So we have done with planning, monitoring, developing. Now let us go ahead with rating.
Fourth, rating. Rating means detailed evaluation of the employee performance in comparison to the set performance goals and objectives, summarizing that performance and assigning a rating of record.
I think way too simple to understand that rating is something which is measurable, something which is quantifiable, something which is going to make the employee aware about his strength and weaknesses in different areas where of his performance. Okay, so rating is a detailed evaluation. Okay, you need to understand managers would be better if the managers are giving rating in numeric as well as if there is something in descriptive form. Okay, so rating will help the employee understand, you know, what are their strengths and weaknesses. Okay, rating will also make them more serious about their job. If I know that, you know, my performance is being rated, okay, which will be utilized for performance appraisals, okay, and my and important decisions will be taken, which will affect my career, I think I will take my job very seriously, right? So rating is something which is very important. Okay, since we have been saying that performance management is more about directing and guiding employees, it should just not stop there. Okay, there should be, if there is a calm approach of guiding and directing your employees, again, there should be an approach that, you know, where you tell your employees, see, your performance is getting weighted. Okay, you will be given certain ratings, and based on that ratings, certain important decisions will be taken. So rating is a detailed evaluation. It's just mentioned over here that, you know, rating will help the employee to check if, you know, they are able to achieve the set standard of performance or not. But I think we have some answers in the next chapter, which will help us to understand how important this rating is. We have already seen one answer, which was dealing about raters' biases. I hope you remember that answer. We have seen several reasons, okay, why the rater is, you know, having a biased approach, sometimes intentionally and sometimes unintentionally. Okay, fifth and the last one.
Fifth, rewarding. Rewarding means rewarding and recognizing of employees individually and as members of groups for their performance and acknowledging their contributions to the organizational goals. There are many ways to appreciate good performance, from a thank you card, an appreciation certificate, to granting the highest level, company-specific honors, and establishing formal cash, incentive, and recognition award programs.
I think rewarding is something which is not just an acknowledgement, okay? It is also one of the motivating factors for any employee to continue working with that company, okay? Rewards should be both. It should be intrinsic and, it should be cash rewards also, and at times there should be some recognition also. Okay. I think companies should decide in advance, okay, or should have a well-planned system of rewards, okay, where the highest or the good performers are given rewards, okay, so that you motivate them, all right? It can be a very simple, a thank you card or an appreciation certificate. Even nowadays, there's something called employee of the month, employee of the year, this kind of company specific honors, or, you know, giving them cash incentives. Okay. An employee who is putting in efforts for your organizational goals and objectives expects certain things in return. Okay. Or that is in form of rewards. So rewards is the last cycle of performance management, okay? And it is a continuous cycle. Okay? After this, again, the company starts with planning, monitoring, developing, rating, and rewarding. I hope there is no difficulty in the answer.
No, ma'am.
Okay, with this, we have completed the first unit. I'll just very quickly summarize what all we have completed from first unit or unit one. We have understood what is the meaning of performance management. I'll just write. Okay, we have understood what is performance management. We have seen the features of performance management. We have seen one answer, which is evolution of performance management, which is having five phases. Okay. After evolution of performance management, we have seen importance or relevance of performance management, right? We have seen an answer which is talking or discussing about the process. Okay. Okay, so process of performance management, we have done that also. After process of performance management, we have seen what are the reasons for raters' biases. Okay. After that, we have also seen what are the best practices in performance management. Okay. Then what is the role of technology in strengthening the performance management process? And then today we have completed performance management cycle. Okay. So these are few answers that we have completed from unit one. Okay. I hope there is no difficulty. In the next session, I will start with unit two. Okay. And if there are any doubts in this unit, you can first refer to the study materials uploaded on Google Classroom or the recorded lectures. In case you still have doubt, you can get back to me. Okay. And in the next session, I'll start with unit two. All right, guys, I stop here. And gentle reminder.